Nobody asked for this video. I'm sorry in advance. Hi, hello guys, it's your girl, mandafitpanda, and I went on a hiatus. Again, like, who gave me a YouTube channel? And why? That's right, nobody did. Anyways, I went on a hiatus, and for good reason. When I came back from Great Lakes, I went straight into an underway, and after I got back from that underway, I needed to decompress, and here we are. During that underway, I decided that I wanted to film what we eat on a regular basis, because I've seen trends on YouTube where people try the keto diet for a week, or paleo, or being vegan, or being gluten-free, or whatever you want to do, whatever tickles your pickle. So I decided that I would do what I eat on a boat for a week. Let's jump into it. And as a disclaimer, I don't want to bring any hate to any persons making this food, especially the culinary specialists on board our ship, or anywhere for that matter, because they honestly can get down with some food. I have seen what they make, and some of it is actually really good. Some days are better than others, but they are working with what they've got. We are on a giant boat, and they are trying to feed over 5,000 people sometimes. So they have to work with what they have. And sometimes it might not always be the best. And sometimes I lose my mind with how good this food is. Also, stay tuned to the end of this video because I have some new fun things that I want to share with you guys. All right, so for starters, I basically wrote down everything I ate that day, or what I remembered to eat, or what I didn't eat. Now, granted, I'm not a nutritionist. I don't pretend like I know what I'm doing anymore, because so please don't try this diet as a way to successfully lose weight or anything like that, because it's not healthy. It isn't. So with that being said, before we started this underway, I decided that I wanted to weigh myself and see the changes, because I've been on a couple of underways and I have noticed the changes from the beginning of the underway to the end. My pants are kind of tight, and at the end, they're pretty loose. Probably because I haven't washed them in a couple of days. I'm disgusting. Actually, that's a joke. We do our laundry twice a week, so it's fine. And I have a couple of pairs of pants, so whatever. I'm not the only one who doesn't wash their pants every day, okay? Just saying. If you do, you're wasting water. So on day one for breakfast, I didn't eat anything because I was too lazy to go down to the mess decks and get breakfast. That was on me. For lunch, however, we went to the ship store, which is available on most Navy boats, I believe. I don't know, I could be wrong. I know for a fact that we have them on carriers. We actually have two ship stores where you are given a cash card and you are able to put money from your bank account to this card, and then you can use this card anywhere on the ship for, you know, sodas, Red Bulls, Monsters, any kind of snacks or anything in the ship store if you run out of stuff. I was very unprepared for this underway and didn't bring any snacks. This one, I just didn't feel like bringing any snacks because I am the only snack I need. My friends and I went to the ship store and bought some snacks, and the spicy noodle was on sale for 75 cents, so we bought a numerous amount. I think I ended up getting neuter and Doritos and a tuna box lunch kit thing. So for lunch on day one, I had neuter and Doritos. And for dinner that day, it was a Taco Tuesday. It was later during the mess deck hours, so there wasn't a lot of options available, and I made a taco crunch wrap thing that was okay. I mean, I wasn't fully complaining. Every day on the mess decks, there is something different to offer. Especially, we have a quick line that you go in, you grab your food, and you just sit down really quickly. Monday, I believe, is deli meats. Tuesday is Taco Tuesday. Wednesday, I want to say, is barbecue. Thursday might be burgers and hot dogs and corn dogs. Friday might be chicken. I don't know. Saturday, I think, is chicken wings and pizza. And then Sunday, I couldn't tell you. I just know that every day is gonna be different, but also the same. On day two, for breakfast, I did manage to wake myself up and go down and get breakfast. And I got eggs, bacon, and coffee bread. Now, I personally love breakfast on the boat. That's one of the things that is really hard to mess up. Sometimes it can happen, but you know, it is what it is. I'm not complaining. I'm very easy to please. And that coffee bread was banging. I remember it was so soft and just like super delicious. I didn't have any coffee to go with it, but it's fine. I'm okay. For lunch and dinner, I had my tuna lunch kit with Doritos. For some reason, I didn't feel like eating dinner that day or didn't have time or what have you. You will find this to be a trend in this video that not every time that there's chow, I didn't have time, didn't feel like going, or it was already closed. That's why I said this isn't probably the healthiest diet. On day three, it was an interesting day. I did not eat breakfast for good reason, because I had some things that I needed to do and it cut right into my breakfast time. I think I had woken up. The second I stepped foot into the shop, they said, you gotta go somewhere. And I went, and it took longer than expected, and I didn't get to eat breakfast. Then lunchtime came around, and I also didn't get to eat lunch. So my best friend Grogan was so sweet and brought me chicken of the sea, cans, barbecue chips, gummy bears, and peanut butter pretzels and a sweet tea. I didn't get this on camera because I was just too excited because of how sweet it was. That was my lunch. Except for the chicken of the sea, the can that I believe she got was already opened and the chicken in there was bad. So I just gave her mine because she's just that great, you know? Sacrifices. And for dinner that day, I had a neuter. Yeah, this is why people have high blood pressure in the Navy, because all we eat is neuter. On day four for breakfast, it was actually a really good breakfast. It was banging, let me tell you. I had eggs, bacon, and these like oniony potatoes. And then they had these French toast sticks on the first class mess that we did not get when we first went through. And I was very upset about it, but I managed to hop back in line and grab me a whole plate for my entire table. And they were so good.
Carl Jr. French sticks.
During breakfast, they also had the peanut butter and jelly sandwiches, the Uncrustable sandwiches. And apologizing for the lighting right now because the sun is setting, therefore time change. So I pocketed like four of those suckers because I knew I wasn't going to be able to eat at some point in time. So I was thinking in advance, you know what I mean? It was a free for all and I was down with it. So to piggyback off of that, I decided to have a peanut butter and jelly and Doritos. That is by far my favorite childhood snack, where you like stick the Doritos in the peanut butter and jelly sandwich. Weird, I know, but you have to try it. Don't knock it until you try it. I'm telling you right now, it is delicious, okay? Just try it, you'll like it. And for dinner, I had the same thing, except I ran out of Doritos, so I had neuter with my peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine.
This is so depressing, oh my God. Like, talking about it sounds insane to me. So for breakfast on day six, I had eggs, a sausage patty, bacon, and hash browns. So hash browns on the boat are like a hit or miss sometimes. Sometimes they're really mushy, sometimes they're really mushy, or sometimes they're like perfect. In this last underway, they had been perfect every time, and I was not upset about it. It was delicious. Also, when I put ketchup on top, ugh. And then every once in a while, you will find a rare bottle of Tapatio, and it's like a godsend. you should see what I write in these things. This shit's hilarious. For lunch, I had cheesecake and cookies. The reason for that is because I had watch right at lunchtime, so we tried to go to, oh, this was Sunday, so we tried to go to brunch. However, the watch bill line was really long, and I was like, there's no way in hell I'm going to make my watch on time. So we just snuck by and grabbed cheesecake and cookies, and that was my lunch. And then for dinner, I literally wrote, I didn't have dinner that day, apparently. All right, and for day 7, the last day of this whole diet extravaganza, for breakfast, I had 2 hard-boiled eggs because they didn't have the powdered eggs, which I wasn't really upset about because they weren't, like, sometimes the hard-boiled eggs are a little weird. And I had 2 hash browns. I had 2 pieces of bacon. So one of the things that sucks is that sometimes a lot of the food is going to be self-serve. A lot of times you have to be aware of what you're grabbing from the mess deck line, because I love bacon. And if I could and it didn't affect me, I would grab a whole plate of bacon, but I can't. Or I would grab a whole plate of hash browns. It's bad, really bad. This was a Monday, so it was the deli meats, and I really don't like deli meats, especially on the boat sometimes. So I had stolen a piece of chicken from my friend because he had 3. I'm like, why do you need 3? What about the rest of us? I stole a piece of chicken from him, and then I had roast beef and cheese squares for lunch. And then dinner came around, and I saw the same person, and I stole another piece of chicken and had no cheese squares, but also roast beef. There were a couple other days where they had Creole mac and they also had lasagna. The lasagna gave me, but it did it to everybody. It was like a vegetable lasagna. I don't know what happened to it, but it was the Creole mac and the lasagna were delicious. They just, sometimes they just don't hit you right. You know what I mean? So to sum this all up, at the end of the underway, I lost 5 pounds. I didn't film me weighing myself, but I just knew because on average, that's the amount of weight that I lose every time we go underway. I did manage to go to the gym at least every day, if not 2-3 days I missed. I definitely 10 out of 10 recommend that you guys go to the gym while you are on the boat, because it is a great way to escape the madness that is the boat. And also, don't get fat from eating neuter and bacon every day. My tips for you guys, if you are going to end up being on a boat, is watch what you eat, because the food will get you. And I can speak for myself, when you have the ability to buy snacks, one, you're gonna waste your money because you always just go and buy snacks on the boat. And 2, the snacks aren't really good for you. So be aware and very mindful of what you do eat when you are underway, because it is very, 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 very important to stay healthy and in some type of physical fit. Don't know what I'm trying to get to. You get weighed twice a year. If you don't make weight, you will end up in FEP, and it is a program that will make you work out. And if you don't like to work out, well, I don't know what to tell you. But again, this video is not to bring any hate towards any of the culinary specialists on our boat or anywhere for that matter. You guys are killing it, doing what you do. I personally love a lot of the food that you guys make, and yeah. I said at the beginning of this video that I had some cool thing that I wanted to, you know, throw out there. Well, I actually know someone on the boat who actually also makes YouTube videos. So his name is Underbar Fitness. That is his YouTube channel. All of the male viewers out there are looking into getting into fitness. I think he's gonna start doing military related videos. We're probably going to collab soon. If you guys are interested, please definitely go check him out. He's starting out. I remember exactly where I was at his point, except I think he's probably doing it a little bit better. I 10 out of 10 recommend that you guys go watch his videos. Tell him that I sent you. And for our collab, I wanted to ask you guys what you would like to see. We have some ideas a brewing. If you guys like this video, please don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. Also, don't forget to go to Underbar Fitness and subscribe to his channel, and leave a comment down below on what you guys want to see us do. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and that is all I have. I am signing off, tuning out. Okay, bye.